we're going to sluice as much as we can this year.
At Paradise Hill, king of the Klondike Tony Beets is running 350 yards of mega-cut pay dirt through his trommel every hour. Ruby Mahoney clears tailings in the loader.
If you keep up at this rate, I think we'll have a very nice total by the end of our season. You know, after everything that happened last year, I think all of us really wanted to have a really good season, kind of like a resurrection season.
If we can get 3,000 ounces out of the ground, be better than last year, that would be good. Anyway, first things first, I'm gonna have breakfast. Can't run around all day on an empty stomach. Morning, Eagan.
Morning.
How are you today?
Good.
Are you ready to go to work?
Sure.
This morning, Tony's grandson Eagan is here to learn the ropes. His mother, Tony's daughter Bianca, is not part of the gold mining business.
Since it is a family operation, it is good to have the third generation like you show up. In the future, maybe your brothers all show up. We'll have a whole crew of grandkids, for Christ's sake. That'd be cool. Anyway, you want to go and drive around, have a look?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it. Welcome to the family business, young fella. Let's go to where we're making the money. Let's go to the drama league and hear all the tailings. Well, you've seen them before, of course, but
yeah.
If you like this kind of stuff, someday you might be a gold miner too.
Yeah.
So basically a general inspection first thing in the morning, what kind of things they screwed up.
And what they did right too.
Yeah, well, right. Give me a break. Hey, Kevin, do you copy? Kevin, do you copy?
Go for Kevin.
You have a look at them tailings lately?
I am on my way there now.
Here, Eagan, I got to talk to your uncle. Can't get away with that.
No, that's terrible. It's not washed at all.
The trommel uses water jets to blast pay dirt off the rocks, sending gold-rich material down to the sluices. Dirty tailings indicate the trommel isn't washing the rocks properly and could be discarding them still covered in gold. They head down the hill to check the pump that supplies the trommel.
Look at it.
Water.
You got nothing but air in it.
The valve is sucking so much air, the pump can't deliver enough water.
The valve used to control the water supply from the pond is cracked. It's sucking in air, causing the pressure in the pump to drop. By the time it gets to the wash plant, the water pressure is so low, it's unable to wash the gold-rich dirt from the rocks. So gold is being lost in the tailings.
Kevin, we gotta cure that. That's no good, right? Take out of there. Well, they wanted the whole posse won't do it. Cure thing.
Every hour the plant is down, Tony loses $2,500 in gold.
So right now the water's still a little high. If we take the valve off now, all the water in the pond's gonna come straight out. It's gonna make a giant mess. So we're gonna have to drain the pond first.
The leaking valve is set below the water level of the pond. If the pond is full when they take it off, nearly 500,000 gallons of water will flood the yard. So before he can change the valve, Kevin must pump water out of the pond to bring the level down.
Once the water's down, we're gonna come down, rip the valve off, put the new one in, hook everything back up, open up the water, and we'll be sluicing again. But for now, we just gotta wait for it to get low enough.
Thank you.
you think?
How much lower is this?
Well, they're gonna go for a while yet.
I think so, yeah.
We need another 4 or 5 feet. So I think what we should do is, I think we'll just shut the pump off and open both valves.
You guess what?
Let it go.
All right.
We'll fix the yard later.
All right.
We're just gonna wash the out of everything.
Okay.
They say, I don't want to wait all day. We want to get going, right? To do.
Impatient to get sluicing.
Stand back.
Tony decides to open the valve while the pond is still full.
Get out of the way. Eagan, what's up?
Hey, that's dangerous.
After an hour draining the pond, the yard is completely flooded. But the pressure is low enough to replace the broken valve.
I think that was all good.
Yeah.
Here you go. Don't stand on the needle load, okay? Yeah, driving in there. It almost looked like a boss, Eagan. Eagan, grab that toolbox and put it over where the clamp is. Same as with the screwdriver. Give that to him there. Okay, put the clamp in. It's a nut. Gentlemen, there you go. Next one. Put it on top. Go, 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 go. There you got two nuts.
I got four here.
Okay, slowly down a little bit. There you go. Rubber clamping. Let's do it.
More.
Okay, Eagan, keep an eye on it. Well, I'm gonna fire the pump. If the thing don't leak, what in business?
That's it. Good enough.
Okay, Eagan, let's go.
Okay.
Well, that went pretty slick, Eagan.
Hey.
I think so.
You lost enough time over it already.
Okay, let's go.
It was down for a day, but the trommel is now back washing pay.
Right, that cleans it up pretty good, isn't it? Looks like it was worth the effort, or what? Oh,
yeah.
You know, maybe had a bit more water. With the valve in, low RPM made all the difference, don't you think so? Can't get any better than that.
Oh, no, any better than that?
I think so.